Hello, we're celebrating our 50th wedding anniversary, and we want to welcome you to take a peek into our lives, at least the beginning stages, and we're happy to be here. I'm Bob.
And I'm Carol.
And God brought us together over a wonderful period of time, and this first slide indicates our three children and our eight grandchildren that God has given us. Stacy married Jeremy Frith, and they have Joey and Emily. Chris married Christina, and they have Sally and Arlo. And Charlie married Patty. They have Jenna, Julia, Nathaniel, and Paisley. We just hope you enjoy taking a peek into our past. We'll have audio of our wedding. You'll meet Pastor Ruth. You'll hear the vocalist from our wedding. You'll hear and see a number of things along the way, and we'll try to bring you along and enjoy the journey. Thank you very much, and enjoy the video.
We met at PCB's freshman orientation, and through our Christian education and Bible courses, we spent lots of class time together and had the opportunity to serve in various ministries around Philadelphia. We grew as a couple, and it was really neat to be able to go out and serve as youth pastor of Carol's home church, and in that process get to know Carol's family as well. Hey, that's how marriages start. You got to start as friends, right?
After we got engaged, my mother wanted to have an engagement party, so she invited friends and family to celebrate with us our engagement. Carol Ann Hall, daughter of Mr. and Mrs. W. Howard Hall, and
Robert Heagy Givens, son of Mr. and Mrs. Alvin L. Givens.
Saturday, August 23rd, 1969,
at Goshen Baptist Church, Westchester, Pennsylvania.
Since we don't have any pictures of our actual processional, I thought I would share some pictures from our wedding rehearsal the evening before. One interesting thing happened as we were getting ready for the wedding, and Carol's father was waiting with Carol at the back. He said, "Bob hasn't arrived yet." That is true. It was 10 minutes before the wedding, and my brother Paul and I were running his car through the car wash in Westchester because he had arrived from a distance and it needed to be cleaned for the getaway to the reception. So when we finally arrived, I had a flower put on my chest. 15 minutes later, we were married, and we've been married 50 years since.
Human society and a joyous occasion, and particularly joyous when those who come are members of the body of Jesus Christ, as Carol and Robert are today. God has declared that it is not good that man should live alone. Let us reverently remember that God has established and sanctified marriage and regulated it by his commandments for the welfare and happiness of mankind. Jesus, our Savior and our Lord, attended the marriage in Cana of Galilee. And it was there that he did his first wonderful work, his first miracle. The Bible instructs those who enter into this relationship to cherish a mutual esteem and love, to bear with each other's infirmities and weaknesses, to comfort each other in sickness, trouble, and sorrow, in honesty and industry to provide for each other and their household, to pray for and encourage each other in things pertaining to God and to live together as heirs of his grace. Who gives this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother.
For as much as these two persons have come to this house of worship to be made one in the Lord in the holy bonds of marriage, it is understood that neither of them nor others present are aware of any just reason why they may not be lawfully joined together. Our God and our Father, thou who art the Lord of all of life, the sovereign Lord of this universe, we pause today to give thee thanks for Jesus, our Savior and our Lord. We thank thee for that purpose which brings us together, and for Robert and Carol as they share together their testimony for Jesus Christ and their union as one in him. We pray that thou would bless and guide and direct in all that is said or done this day. For we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Robert, will you take Carol to be your wife, to live together in the holy bond of marriage, according to God's ordinance, and will you promise in the presence of God and before these witnesses to love her and comfort her, honor and cherish her, in sickness and in health, in prosperity and in adversity, and forsaking all others, remain faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Carol, will you take Robert to be your husband, to live together in the holy bond of marriage, according to God's ordinance, and will you promise in the presence of God and before these witnesses to love him and comfort him, honor and obey him, in sickness and in health, in prosperity and in adversity, and forsaking all others, remain faithful to him as long as you both shall live? You repeat, Robert, these vows. I, Robert, take you, Carol.
I, Robert, take you, Carol.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
I do promise and covenant.
I do promise and covenant.
Before God and these witnesses.
Before God and these witnesses.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
To be your loving and faithful husband.
In plenty and in want.
In
joy and in sorrow.
In joy and in sorrow.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
As long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live.
Carol, will you repeat? I, Carol, take you, Robert.
I, Carol, take you, Robert.
To be my husband. And I do promise and covenant. Before God and these witnesses. To be your loving and faithful wife, in plenty and in want, in joy and in sorrow, in sickness and in health, as long as we both shall live. This morning, as the wedding party entered, there were two candles burning. The two parties are single individuals today, but they would like to represent their testimony for Jesus Christ and the bonds of marriage, that they are no longer two but one together and in the Lord. And symbolically, the lighting of the third candle will be representative of this truth. The rings are the symbol of eternity and completeness, perfection. They are representative also of the personal testimony of Bob and Carol today. As our youth workers in the church, we have come to know their witness for Jesus Christ exceedingly well, and we rejoice in their life for the Lord. The ring is a medal that has been tested and proven true. It is a fitting emblem of your love for each other and of your faith in each other. And I pray that your love and faith will prove as true in the test of time as this gold does in the fire. May they endure until death do you part. Repeat after me. This ring I give.
This ring I give.
In token and pledge.
In token and pledge.
Of my constant faith.
Of my constant faith.
And abiding love.
And abiding love.
Repeat after me. This ring I give.
This ring I give.
In token and pledge
of
my constant faith and abiding love. Let us bow in prayer. Sanctify, O Lord, by thy grace and through the power of thy Spirit, Robert and Carol, as they have declared together today their faith in thee and their love and faith in one another. We pray, O God, that the test of time may strengthen this union, may bring to them greater and deeper love for each other and for thee. May there be glory and praise for our Lord Jesus Christ as their lives reflect thy love and thy grace. We pray thou will bless each one of us who have gathered here today, and our witness for him, we pray, may be strengthened because of our joining together in this ceremony. For we ask in the name and for the sake of Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Give thee peace, now and until Jesus comes and forevermore.